Okay, the headline of the day, Mercury turning stationary retrograde today. The energy is with us until April 25th, and it's not until about a week after that that we are finally through the energy completely. Now, today we will be looking at, what to recognize, some of the challenges that this energy brings in, as well as the wisdom that we can gain and the understanding that we can take in from this energy that we are gifted with. So sit back, relax. Let's explore the cosmic energies together. We will gain an understanding of how to embrace this energy, own this energy, move forward today and every day. So hi, I'm Tilly. This is Tarot with Tilly. Thank you for all the positive, loving support you send me each and every day. Thank you for being here. Welcome to your daily focus for April the 1st, 2024. Rabbit, rabbit. So, if you want good luck for the month, you're to say rabbit, rabbit. And I know that a lot of you have different customs, so put it down in the comments and let's educate each other on how to bring luck in by what we say on the first of every month. Everybody has their own traditions, and it's just kind of wonderful. And it's free to do them all, right? Doesn't cost us anything. So, why not? Okay, the numerology. Now, before we go into the daily energy, let's take a fast peek at the energy of April. Okay, so April's the fourth month, therefore it carries the energy of the four. So it's about having our ducks in a row. It's about building our foundations strong and true. It's about bringing in a balance, being centered, feeling confidence, building the confidence, making the plan, making the strategy. It's also has a lot to do with home and family and building the safety and security within the home and family. Now, in order to find the collective energy for April 2024, we need to add the 4 for April and the 8 for 2024 together. And 4 plus 8 is a 12, and that is the hangman energy. That is about observing. Looking at what we are going through on a logical level, to stand back and disconnect from the emotion as much as possible, to see what's really going on, to see where we have maybe been falling towards an illusion or a lie. We don't have our facts straight. We're getting too emotional. We're too invested. We're too close to the situation, perhaps. It's a time of being in the moment. It's a time of not rushing through everything, but taking our time, really thinking things through, understanding where we have control in our life, where we need control in our life, where we need to let go of control in our life, perhaps places in our life where we need to surrender to the energy instead of fighting the current constantly. And 1 plus 2 is the 3 energy. So it's about the transformation, the growth, communication. So, isn't it funny how our 3 energy is also intertwined with Mercury, which is the challenge to our communications? So, expect a lot of growth when it comes to how we get the message across, what words we use, how we talk, how we speak, how we communicate, and how we can be more effective in the process of doing all that. Today, we have the one energy. The one energy is the I am. The one energy is so amazing to start off April because the energy of the one is so vibrant and alive. Okay, we will have the solar eclipse in Aries, which is our first sign. Okay, marking not only a new beginning. Okay, I just put out the weeklies. And about halfway through, I decided to just, take a break, shake my head, and do a little bit of research on the eclipse that's coming. And wow, have I ever downplayed the energy of what can possibly be in our lives when it comes to new paths? I mean, do not expect a new path to open to you. Expect several new paths. On top of it, we'll have Jupiter and Uranus conjunct in the sky at the exact same time of the solar eclipse. That just brings the expansion of, what we truly want, especially, they're both sitting in the second house, which is our money house. collectively. So it's about bringing in prosperity and abundance in unexpected and serendipity ways. And how, you know, and if you don't want to tap into this energy, that's fine. I mean, it'll be around in about 84 years again, so you can catch it then. But really to bring in abundance and prosperity and leaps and bounds if we just follow certain footsteps during this period of time. I mean, and if you look at the chart, okay, you usually see a wheel and then you got planets here and there. And all the planets are right here together. Okay, I think the farthest one away is like Neptune's here, and then, but that's in Aquarius, which isn't that far away. There's, I think, three in Pisces, all of them are in Aries, and then we have the two in Taurus, right? And they're all there up in the sky, and if you go to the eclipse time, it's right at the top of the sky, meaning it's shooting towards success, the top of the chart. I mean, it's just extraordinary. So if you're expecting, I mean, go and watch your weeklies and then times that energy by 10. I downplayed it. That's the very minimum. What I told you is the very minimum of what you can expect, okay? So just expect a lot more than what I even added to your energy. And they took time. I mean, these are long videos this time. I think last week they averaged about 15 minutes. I think these ones average about 25 minutes. But I wanted to get in all the information. This is a pivotal time in, we'll never see this energy again. This energy of creation, of being in control of the creation, being in control of what our life can look like if we take control, if we make the commitment, if we start. I won't go into it all here, but you know, it's a lot of what I have been saying. So if you listen to me taking notes, I know a lot of you take notes, then read through your notes and you'll start to see the key things that I've been telling you to do. It is a very opportune time that we'll never see on this planet again. So magic comes around once in a while, and this is one of those times when magic is definitely alive. Anyways, the one energy, sorry, I got off on a tangent there. The one energy is all about the I am, the new opportunities, the new adventures, being the independent, being the trailblazer, being the pioneer, stepping into our truest passions. And if we look at the daily numerology, 3 plus 1 plus 8, it's a 12 energy. So we've already gone through the 12 and the 3. Just know that those numbers are electrified in our life today. Now we'll dive into the astrology fast. The sun is in Aries, the moon is in Capricorn, and the headline of the day, of course, is Mercury goes stationary retrograde in Aries. And when Mercury turns retrograde in Aries, it kind of brings in this period marked by potential changes, challenges, mixed signals, disruptions. Disruptions in our communication, and we're traveling, getting from A to B. And all this stuff, of course, creates and leads to tension in our life. And we start doing some impulsive decision making, which is probably the worst thing that we can do under this energy. So we can find ourselves kind of grappling with confusing or conflicting information. Things aren't spoken clearly. They're not written clearly. We're trying to read between the lines. There's no lines to read between. It makes it crucial under this kind of energy to exercise caution in all communications. Like if you're sending out an email, read it twice over, then shut it down and go back to it an hour later, or have somebody proofread it before you send it out. There'll be words missing, sentences missing, unclear facts. It's just, you know, we mismanage a lot of our communication under this energy. Things are forgotten to be said. Things are added in that shouldn't have been said. So we can see this arising quite frequently over the next month, and it will require extra patience. It will require us to slow down and make sure that we are being clear, giving clarity when expressing our thoughts, our intentions. Travel is another thing, okay? Our plans are subject to the unexpected changes, delays, cancellations, there's an accident, there's a shutdown. The lights aren't working. There's construction over here. We may need to be just a little bit more flexible and adaptable. So double check any long distant travel arrangements, absolutely, and allow extra time for any unforeseen events, because chances are we're going to hit something along the way. Now, on a personal level, Mercury retrograde in Aries, and I did put out a Mercury retrograde video. I'll try to remember to attach it to the end of this so you can go back. I put it out a while ago, so some of you have seen it already, but for those who want a refresher or have not seen it yet, it'll be available. Anyways, on a personal level, Mercury in Aries. Deja vu is a big part of it. When it's in Aries, we may reminisce about past experience, past people, and we may have unexpected encounters with old friends. Somebody from the past knocks on our door, or we see somebody and it reminds us of that person. In order to bring us back to reminiscing about maybe the good times, maybe the bad times, but it's there to point something out to us, so pay attention to that very closely. They're trying to highlight a period of our life that we went through something to remind ourselves of maybe the wisdom that we gained from that experience. So definitely it's stirring up emotions, it's stirring up feelings from our memories of the past. But despite all the challenges posed by Mercury retrograde, and we don't want to sign things. Now people always ask, what if I have to sign? If you have to sign, then you have to sign. What Mercury retrograde really is slow down. If you don't have to do it, then I'd probably highly advise not to do it. But chances are, in this fast-paced world we live in, we can't wait until May, maybe, to sign the document. And so reread it. Have somebody read it for you. Make sure you're reading the fine print. Make sure all your questions are answered. Okay? And it is what it is. And chances are you'll be just fine if you just, do your due diligence. But this period offers an opportunity for reflection, to reassess, to revise. It's a time to look at our plans, our strategies, our goals. It's time to address any kind of unresolved issues from the past, realign our intentions, with our true desires, with our true passions. It's kind of like writing us on the path. So approach this retrograde period with a mindfulness, a willingness to learn from the past experiences. Okay, you'll be able to navigate its challenges with a greater ease, emerge with valuable insights, and you'll definitely pave the way for your own personal growth and evolution. So let's turn to the cards. Okay, underlying energy for this week is, look at this, the Wheel of Fortune, telling us that the seasons are changing. Well, we are right smack dab in the middle of the eclipse season. Okay, last week we had the lunar eclipse. Next week on Monday we will have the solar eclipse, which will be just one of the most amazing solar eclipses we'll have probably for the century. So I'll be talking a lot about that and hopefully be able to give you some kind of footage or something, because my property seems to sit right on a prime spot to see the solar eclipse. So I don't have to go anywhere. I just have to go into my backyard and enjoy it. So, I think we're in a state of emergency. They're stating it as, because we figure, well, there'll be so many people coming into our area to witness the solar eclipse this year. So I bought my t-shirt already. I was wearing it the other day for one of the videos. I'm excited. Are you excited? Let's all get excited about that. It's really going to bring in a beautiful energy for us all. The Wheel of Fortune does say that we are going into a lighter energy, a more beautiful time. A new season perhaps is emerging in our life. This is a time to journal, okay? Not this past week, not the ones that are for this week, not those weeklies, but the previous weeklies. I think everybody got the homework of journaling. Journaling what you want your life to look like, okay? Use that solar eclipse as the springboard as of the solar eclipse, what will your life entail? What will it look like? What kind of opportunities and adventures and paths will you seek going forward? Prosperity, abundance, it's all on the table. It really is under this kind of energy. So seasons changing, lighter energy coming in. We have the hermit. The hermit is telling us to look in the here and now where we are at. I look at the hermit as somebody who goes into a cave or a desert, spends some time in meditation and prayer, in contemplation about their path forward. And then when they emerge, they have a plan, they have a strategy, they know where they're going, they have an idea of what they want to grow as far as their wisdom and what they want to grow. And so we too must sit in silence, we must look at our surroundings, we must see what is in the here and now for us to utilize going forward. And that might be your talents, your abilities, just the unique self. It may be other things, it might be your time, your energy, your resources. But we look at what we have to work with, and then we look at where we want to go, and we start to devise a plan, a strategy to walk in that direction. We have the Ten of Wands. The Ten of Wands is now stopped because you cannot go forward into a solar eclipse energy of all energies for new moon energies. You cannot go into this burdened down, weighed down, so much responsibility, obligations, control over things. You need to lighten the load. You need to stop. Now, every one of those wands shows different parts of our path that we are walking, our health, our well-being, our obligations, our responsibility, our job, our career, what we do in the community. And some of it all has great growth potential, as we can see. But some of it is deadwood, and we need to get rid of the deadwood, what is no longer working for us, what no longer supports us in our path going forward. We need to leave it in our rearview mirror. It is a time for completions, endings, and moving forward without those struggles. And then we have the Three of Cups, which is all about having fun, joy, laughter, celebration, inviting in happiness. This could also be good news coming in. So if you were hoping for that phone call or that email giving you the thumbs up, it's a go ahead. All systems ready to go, right? Ready for takeoff. So this is the time to get together and socialize with other people, socialize for purpose maybe, but I think the main purpose should be just the celebration of being in each other's presence, celebrating the moment. And if you don't have something to celebrate, you know, think of something, make something up. It's okay. Every day that we can celebrate is a good day. So, but I think good news could come in for many of us, or we hear of somebody else's good news that causes us to want the need to celebrate their happiness, their joy. Oh, we had a card try and jump. Okay, we have renewal of peace, the 13 energy, the 4 energy. So we've talked about the 4 energy already today. It is already with us. We get this through the 13 energy. Did we have the 4? I think we have the 4. Yeah, April is the 4. I was wondering how we got the 4. Okay. Renewal of peace. This artist is so magnificent in putting pictures within the pictures. We see so much more. It is important to maintain peace with all aspects of your life, mental, emotional, physical, and spiritual. Inner imbalances can often manifest in our daily life if you don't make time to take care of yourself. It doesn't matter whether or not your imbalance is a negative one. Being optimistic to the point of believing yourself to be invincible can also lead to challenges. Balance is best achieved through listening to your body. Take time for yourself, allow your inner power to heal, and return to being peace-filled. This will assist you and make you stronger. So yes, definitely the disconnect when we recharge our batteries. Take time out for ourselves actually makes us stronger, more competent. Did we just get one out? No, that's a handful. So, but the owl was at the top. We got everybody wanting to jump here today, so I better cut the cards. And who do we have? We have the bison, abundance. Sacred buffalo, cloak me in your wisdom. Keep me warm through the storms in life. Fill my life with goodness. Teach me the way of gratitude and prayer. Now, with the bisons will walk into a storm. Okay? So they walk through the storm to get to the other side of it, where there is no storm, where it's calm, where they can relax, where they're safe. Cows, on the other hand, will walk away from the storm. And so the storm is always right nipping at their toes, kind of thing, right? So they're always running away from, moving away from the storm, where the bisons hit the storm dead on and, you know, experience very little of the storm because they're actually pushing through the storm to get to the other side where they know there is peace, they know there's calm. So, I mean, this could be pushing through the chaos in our life to that moment of silence, of solitude, and doing whatever you can to get to that peace of mind moment. Okay, so it may be, yeah, you have to go through all the traffic jams and whatnot to get home. But once you're home, take the time to take that deep breath and decompress, because now you know that the storm is behind you. Now you know you are free from all the chaos that you had just experienced. Keep me warm through your storms in life. Fill my life with goodness and teach me the way of gratitude and prayer. Gratitude is so vitally important. We had the hermit today asking us to look around in our environments and be grateful for the things that we have to work with that support us, that can help us move forward in the direction of abundance, joy, celebration. Until we meet again, remember, I do love you.